Hello, universe. How goes it? Have a seat for a little dealer's choice, because if there's one thing that I am confident I can outgame the universe in, well, a game of heads up Texas Hold'em might be my choice. Or tic-tac-toe, because you figure that just goes into a loop of infinite regress that keeps you alive forever, even if all you do for the rest of that time is play tic-tac-toe. Perhaps losing heads up Texas Hold'em would be a better fate. But today we don't have to do either. I will not be playing tic-tac-toe for eternity, I hope. Nor will I be taking you on in heads up Texas Hold'em. I don't think. At least, not in the next 20 minutes. 20 minutes, let's face it, this is episode 52. That's the shuffling of the deck. See, we brought a physical metaphor for the one and only time I'll use that. May the force be with you. The challenge of going through all 51 previous episodes in a composite attempt at summation of what I was up to, especially when the initial project was called Wate.Wut? Well, the absurdity of it finally caught up to me. But that doesn't mean that I don't have reflective, conceptual considerations, conflating contours, connected, containing. That's as far as that goes. Anyway, obviously I smoked a little weed, but how was I going to get through a Wate.Wut review without Strawberry Diesel, I believe, joined in on the AK-47 parade today, and they were both seen being confidential in LA, and so triple up. Hello, creative, energetic, nonsense. It's basically what Wate.Wut was all about. Oh, the mine was dribbling diamonds because I was willing to take them. What's interesting about having literally shifted perspectives, as if I started as an archer and somewhere in the third act of a six-pack expansion set got switched to a mage. And now instead of using arrows looking for quivers, all I want are spells and tomes. And so that's how 180 things like, wow, look at all these mines dribbling out of the... Or look at all these mines. Look at all the diamonds dribbling out of this mine. Good thing I brought my bag and big pockets. Instead of, well, what are all these diamonds doing laying about? Somebody, this isn't right. This needs to be fixed. How do you go from one to the other? Years and years of therapy? No. Soulless chasing of academic truth? New, constant honeypot initiations, no, soul searching at the most personal level, no. I don't know how it happened, but it did. Now, is that fair? No. How can I explain to you the epiphany that means I found meaning in life when I can't even explain it to myself? I don't know. I figure that's part of the reason that I've been impulsively directed from within and from some external influences to just start documenting who I am now and why that transition matters to me. I'm not sure this has value to anybody else. I'm not even sure it has value to me. But I know I have to do it. So self-important much? Yeah, I guess I get that. Like, what makes my story more valuable than anybody else's? I don't think it is. I'm just saying my story finally has narrative purpose. Whereas before, it was just a series of Sunday morning cartoons that didn't relate. Some of them were funny, some of them were tragic, some of them were, frankly, we're not even sure why they're in the Sunday comics. And some of them, I just didn't get any of what was going on. But now it's like I picked up the anthology of Calvin and Hobbes, and every single next frame builds on the last one. And it all is creating such a meaningful universe. Bill Watterson, you're amazing, by the way. So I don't think I'm self-important, but I think all of our stories have value, have extreme value. If anything, if this project creates the spark of, hey, that would be something that would interest me to do for anybody out there. For all my life, I wish I had kept a journal. I just don't have the patience or the drive and tenacity for it. I certainly don't have the dedication for it. Whatever 7-day, 16-day, 14-day, 38-day journal efforts I gave before, they all fizzled out. So this isn't self-important, but it's important. I hope. That could be a delusion. I'll revisit that one because I don't want to feel self-important, but I do want to feel self-value, and I do love myself. So if you don't think I'm going to express how much I care to share what I think is wonderful about me with the universe, then what the fuck, man? Out of the way. You're a hindrance. And the biggest part of this project is I don't connect to anything, but I found connections through the Mandela effect that mattered to me. And once that little spark got lit, now I want it to burn and I want it to rage. I want an inferno of the value that those people showed me was out there. So here's my stumble bumble attempt to reach out and say, I'm here too. I'm just here. I'm not trying to do anything that's of anything other than a rewarding life meant lived purposefully for me. And if I can have other people in that ride that have the same energy and are accomplishing the same initiatives, I'll build a boat big enough to house every single one of you. Not that I know how to build a boat. Not that I wanted to go to a Noah's Ark reference. That wasn't intended. However, it's all inclusive. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker. Hello, Hans Gruber. Or Severus Snape, depending on your generation. When I say I'm trained not to like myself, so much of messaging is designed to create winners and losers. And am I a loser? No, nobody's a loser. Anybody out there thinking you're a loser? You're wrong. You are wrong. You are a winner. How did you win? You got to be a human being. Think about it. Think about what winning is. Let's see. I'd like to play a game where I'm this yellow dot that eats other dots, getting chased by ghosts endlessly forever and ever. And I would like to cost 25 cents a turn. Well, you should have aimed higher. Because think if you had manifested inside of a game where, A, you had free will and actionable thought of your own design. B, you were in an environment in which there was material you could manipulate. And C, you could take those two initiatives and combine them into whatever manipulation of that space you wanted. And no, we are not playing fucking Minecraft. We are here playing human being. Come play with me. Let's all play together. Let's have fun in this initiative. Let's stop getting in each other's way. Let's stop putting out ceilings for each other's limitations. Let's stop harassing each other over who we truly are and embracing the differences among us. Let's stop being so small. We are capable of anything. And yet, what have we got? Reluctance, disappointment, unsteadiness, frankly, destruction, divisiveness. Again, this is a personal project of a lunatic trying to get his light bulb screwed into the right socket. But I feel like I'm starting to illuminate. I want to shine bright. The world does to us what it does to us, right? But how many dryers are we tumbling within that we don't even know about? Seriously. Like, how would you know if you were born into a universe on a tumble setting and just thought, well, this is it. This is how it works. I think many of the things that I think, I was born into a dryer on tumble settings and believe that's how the universe is. No, it's not. We are making the universe tumble. And I don't even know why. I really don't. Like, I'm not, I say I understand all of you, but the motivation to hoard and preside over, to rise in some sort of position of preeminence, that is as far from what I can relate to as pedophilia. Like, I have no desire to rule the world, Tears for Fears. I'm one guy that doesn't want to rule the world. I don't even want there to be a ruler of the world. Now, I don't know that that's a possible scenario. I haven't figured out how we can be the still, calm pond of no variance. Water does find its level, all you F-ears. But why are we choosing patterns that invite rogue waves? I get that it might be choppy. I get that it might be a running stream. But why do we have to get obliterated now and again by our own misdeeds and mistakes? Why? Why does that have to be part of the equation? When I say we're capable of anything, unfortunately, we're capable of anything. That doesn't mean that we can't see all the ascension capabilities and chase those down. Since we've been spending so much time putting up all these sandbags, hoping to stave off the flood that we know with all the cloud seeding is imminent. Blah! Okay. So, the journey has just begun. But more important than anything else was that I get something done. That I finish and achieve what I consider closure on module one. Wait, what? Seriously, I did this. And considering how many false starts I've had, the grade I have to give myself for the overall effort here is an A-. An A- because it was supposed to start on January 1st, and I'm acknowledging that that makes this an imperfect effort, and so it can't be an A. And there are plenty of things I regret, so it's definitely not an A+. And I think an A- is fair. Because when you break down the internal grades, of which I have four for myself, I set a grade in this proceeding for on time. I'll give myself a C+ there. I have room to improve, but I passed this class. I would certainly be able to move on to on time 102 with my effort. And given my challenges, if I just keep making progress, sooner or later my on time grade will be an A. My be kind grade is a B-. I was kind to a lot of people in the last month. I actually have some really proud moments of my kindness. But I always do. Like, I'm kind first, so of course I have kind moments. That's what I do. But there were times when I wasn't as kind as I should have been, and I recognized those, and I even shared some of those, but I didn't share all of them. So my be kind grade is a B-. there's one that I hope to improve and stabilize in the A range, because again, that's who I am. That's me first. My understanding grade was a B. I think this is probably where I did my best over the month, both in self-awareness and understanding the universe and coming to some realizations about behaviors that I hadn't known were there. And I like that side of documentation as much as anything, is being able to remember things that maybe I had transgressed and come back to those without letting them drift off. And my forgiving grade is a C, because I don't think I was very forgiving, especially toward the people in my immediate orbit that I have really gaps to improve. Coworkers and random associates. Family, I think I was very forgiving. And that very might be too generous, but I was forgiving. And uniquely forgiving toward both my parents. Anyway, I give myself a C there. This is not prescriptive. Look, I love myself, and I love all of you. So do I think that through some sort of dialogue, conversation, and sharing of who we are, that maybe there is some prescriptive to be had? Sure, of course. I won't deny that. But I also won't deny that this one-way conversation, it would be, I mean, we want to talk about self-important. This conversation, it is the definition of self-important. I'm the only one talking. I'm the only one making the agenda, and I'm the only one who has any say. So how important can this be to you? Well, I can be your friend. I can be your crying shoulder. I can be your, at least my life's going better than that guy's. I can be your sense of perspective. But I can't truly elevate without being in your presence. And you can't truly elevate me without the same. So this isn't prescriptive. It might be comforting. It might be resonating. It might be distressing. It might be frustrating. It might be meaningless. It might be meaningful. But as connective as those things are, I think the prescriptive elevation I speak of has to be person to person. So that's why we'll be getting out in the public here when the weather turns nicer, and I hear we're going to get some snow, so blackety black. But it's been a cold month, and I guess in many ways that's good, because it's kept me inside pushing the red button. But when it gets warm, well, we'll get out there and see what we can do about sharing kindness, understanding, and forgiveness with the rest of the universe. Wait, what? If I have one overall message, it's that somewhere along the line here in the last 4 to 10 years, or 2 to 8 years, or sometime in this last decade, I either finally had all my random jagged pieces connect and come into closure to form the complete me, or the simulation updated in this version of myself is much more attuned to how to behave in a productive and meaningful and rewarding and soul-satisfying manner than the version that I had been playing before. Either way, here I am. And I'm in a universe that feels completely unsettling to me. Why I think this is all my fault is because I was always okay with that unsettled presence when I was an unsettled person. But if I'm a settled person, I'm not going to live in an unsettled universe. So, wait, what? Settled person Says who? I agree. Like, says who is right, which is why I'm doing this. I feel this is all tenuous. I feel this could all come apart at any minute. And yet I feel like if I continue to document my sanity, I can stave off anything other than staying this version of myself that I love. I want to share this version of myself with everybody. And I want everybody to share their best version of themselves with me. If that's where this all ends up, well, then I will have changed the universe.